want to welcome back. We're back again. Storm here.
Mom here.
Kimmy here.
We're going to be watching more Better Call Saul today, guys. Are you excited?
I love it.
We're on episode 8 of season 2. This one's called, it looks like Fifi. I have it blocked because I didn't want to see the thumbnail. I saw it briefly and I didn't read the description, but I was kind of worried. So it kind of spoils stuff, I think. But anyways, yes, Fifi. Yes. Do we know a Fifi? Fifi?
Is it a dog, a cat, or a 50-50?
Oh, that's a good way to see it.
Spinoff.
Yeah, yeah, I think like dog or something. What's a dog's name that Mike adopted?
You know, I don't know.
Did we ever find the name out? Maybe that's a dog.
That dog.
Fifi needs treatment.
Needs to go to that another job. Get another job.
That's right.
Yeah. So we were just talking about Stacy and how we like her and it sucks because she keeps using Mike now for money.
Taking
and
advantage
she's just, yeah, looking the other way. Like, she knows he's doing bad jobs to afford these big, extravagant things she wants. Even though the house, I mean, it's pretty huge. To me, it's extravagant. I mean, I know you can go bigger, but still, for her.
Well, I think what sells me on her wanting more money out of Mike is, I mean, she's a single mom. She probably didn't get much out of the police funds, if there is anything, because he was killed in the line of duty, right? Mm-hmm. Kind of, sort of.
Kind of, so, I think they killed, it's all corrupted.
But money is an object. I mean, if you don't have, I mean, when you're looking for a place to buy, money is everything. What's the price?
Yeah, you have to have funds
and
for it.
And when she's going in there and selling it to Mike, like, isn't this great? And then in
but
the last
now I
room,
need money.
You know, the only problem is
that's a big problem.
I really can't, you know, I really need a little bit more.
And I need money. I need you to be able to pay for it. Yeah.
And to do that in front of Mike is telling me
while
that
you're there,
he just wants him to pay.
It's like cornering someone.
That's right.
Taking advantage completely of someone. So it just sucks. And I mean, I don't know.
And yeah, she's going through a lot. I mean, yes, her husband died, you know, gunshot. I mean, she wanted to get away from that neighborhood that she thought she was.
Yeah, but don't take advantage of the situation.
So now it's and it seems like he's totally for it. Of course, he wants to do anything he can for his grandkid and her. Yeah. But
I know he really loves his granddaughter so
like
much, too.
She knows like she's a daughter to him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now they're starting to bond and get closer, but not for the right reasons, I guess. And it makes me nervous, too, because last time she was so paranoid about, like, look, that was a gunshot. That wasn't there before and hearing it at night. So it's almost like she's, I know she's terrified, but she's making up all this stuff in her head, too. So is she going crazy? Is she getting overly paranoid? Or
well,
is she just manipulating Mike and that's it? Or is there a bunch of things mixed in?
Yeah, it could be, you know, she's very upset about what happened to her husband. And she's just putting that in the mix on top of it. Like, are they coming out to get me? I had this money that he made doing whatever. And can I spend it? Oh, no, I spent it. Is someone out to get me? Just, you know, is probably playing head games with her, you know? Mm-hmm. And he's just letting her do it because he wants to help her.
Mm-hmm. He's a good person. And it's fun seeing these characters that have so much, you know, like so much development where they're not really good. They're not, well, they're kind of bad, like Mike, because he goes down this path of being terrible and like murdering people. Mm-hmm. And we really care for him still. Like, people have a story. And, you know, he really loves his grandchild. And he really does care for Stacy now. So
yes, he does.
It's a sucky situation.
That's his only family he has.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. So and he really did love his son so much. Like, he loved his son. And this is how he's trying to make up for his loss, you know.
What happened,
And the guilt.
Yeah. And going to Jimmy now, too. Like, what is his decision going to be?
Yeah, I wonder what that's
a square peg.
Oh,
wow. Yeah.
I'm glad Kim countered her idea.
Yes.
But I'm happy he wanted to partner with her. But at the same time, like, she's straight arrow. She's, like, going
to
do things correctly.
She wants to do this for the long haul.
Yeah.
And he really should do the same. But he just wants to rebel and be different. You know, he's colorful. Like, he brought the suits out.
He is. He's got to turn that switch on that's not supposed to be turned on.
That's right.
Yeah, that's the way he rules.
If he does agree that he'll go not into business but have the same location as her or whatever, do you think that'll even work out for them or no?
I don't know. I don't I don't think after a while.
I don't
might
know.
Try,
I...
If he does accept it and they try it, I don't think it's going to last long.
Yeah. Because if he starts bringing in colorful characters, and I mean that because of his suits, but it's just like strange characters that, like, look how he started doing this show where these people who rape the head, you know?
Yeah,
he starts bringing in odd clients. Kim might oppose to that. Who knows what might happen?
That's
I don't know.
True, yeah.
I don't see it working out. I don't see it working out at all. But we will find out. So shall we, ladies?
Yes.
Yes.
We'll get into it. Yes. It is a fun show. All right, so don't read the description. We
can't see it.
All right, so 208.
Tick tock. Who's going to get pulled?
Yeah.
That little truck. Mm-hmm. Turn to the left. Oh,
yeah,
you picked
okay.
out.
Yeah.
There's a big dental mirror. Oh. That's great. They're so thorough.
He's free to go.
Can you help me with that stuff that you just took out?
Something happened.
Like they took the top ones. It could be anywhere.
Yeah, look where we bought them.
What the heck?
Can we go pee behind a weed?
Well, he's part of some.
Let's see.
I love how they do that with a glass underneath and you're looking below.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, it just happens.
Oh, so this is a thing.
Oh, wow.
This is so scary.
What hey, Kim, can we make this quick?
Oh, don't be that much of a jerk.
Go ahead and rip off the Band-Aid. I have a pretty good idea why you're here. So, you're going with Schweiger and Coakley.
I'm sorry? I'm not going to another firm. I'm starting my own. I figured I'd try giving it a go as a solo practitioner.
Well,
it's not.
Why should you share?
We're going to be sharing expenses. One office, but two separate practices.
Smart.
And I'm ready to write a check for the remainder of the loan. I just need accounting to get me that figure.
No need. Our gift to you.
Well, that's good. Yeah. He probably feels better that she's not going with the other guys.
Yes.
Yeah. She's relieved. Yeah.
Call now.
Whoa. Sorry. Well, before we meet, there's some news you need to know about.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I hope it works out for her.
She runs fast in those heels.
Ooh. Oh. Stay right there. Don't go.
Fancy car. Ding, 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 ding.
Hmm.
Just looking around too. It's like you guys have no clue.
I know your bank's needs in regard to this expansion, inside and out. Having Mesa Verde as my sole client will take up the entirety of my attention, to be sure.
That's a hard job, man.
Yeah,
I cannot do that.
Yeah, not only do you have to be an attorney, you have to be a marketing
professional and positive, I guess.
Wow.
What you...
Rainbow.
That's
right.
Dental chair.
Wow.
I think it's a dentist's office.
Two offices for two dentists. Bad lunch, huh? Mesa Verde said no.
I guess she got it.
She's scared. She got it.
Jimmy, I got it.
Double barrel.
Boom, boom. Just like that.
I knew it. I knew you could do it.
I hope that's
just
good. Oh my gosh.
Perfect.
Let's do it.
Hell yeah.
Oh, good. Hey.
Let's do it.
Oh, that's good.
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
Yeah. Ernesto, the door is open.
As always.
Ernesto.
You're too polite.
It's me.
Might not be.
Oh, hey, Howard.
It's likely that we're losing Mesa Verde.
Losing them? We just got them. Why? Where are they going?
They're going with Kim Wexler.
Why is she going out on her own?
Well, the why is the why. The how is that she's pooling her resources with Jimmy.
Uh-oh.
So if you have any details, any arguments, bullet point them for me now, because I got about an hour before I have to get back.
Chuck.
Always going to go in?
I will make it through.
He'll do anything to
hurt Jimmy. Jimmy, against you.
What?
It's like, oh no, did you put your phone away?
No, I'm here to put your minds at ease. Kim Wexler is indeed the right choice to handle Mesa Verde.
But?
She's the obvious choice. She's brilliant. When you've specialized in this kind of work for decades on end, you tend to get kind of...
See, he's throwing
stale,
his experience
stale.
At
stale.
It.
You guys have all that covered, I'm sure.
Regal Neal, he's just letting them know.
State Banking and Branching Efficiency the Act. There's another mouthful, huh? Boring. They know that, Howard. Oh. I apologize. When you reach your golden years, you tend to get a little long.
Sabotaging her.
Ramble on and on about details. You won't find better than Kim Wexler. But no matter how talented one individual may be,
one
needs
individual.
A Mesa Verde or two mm-hmm. big to handle
a
alone.
Team. I
talk soon. Chuck, that sucks.
That. That was amazing. You were fantastic. Truly. Oh. Chuck?
Okay, yeah.
So will there's a way.
Yeah, when he's determined, that's all that matters.
Yeah, that's what it is. Moment. He doesn't care about anything
else. Matters.
You excited?
Uh-huh. Yeah, excited.
Yeah.
Gentlemen.
Fifi.
Meet Fifi, the world's last airworthy between
Fifi.
He says you're welcome.
Oh, jeez.
Did he fly over the hump or did he take off out of India?
Hey,
you doing okay? You need some water?
Oh, could he just jab them to get him to come?
Oh, my gosh. Wow.
That's great. And there's no rush. He's going to be fine. I'll be back ASAP.
He's gonna run. He's
so sweet.
Oh, jeez.
This guy, you couldn't get a real war hero?
Yeah, like they grow on trees. This guy owes me.
Oh,
I defended him a while back when he couldn't pay.
Defended
for
what? Public masturbation.
Keep your voice down.
Oh, my.
You can just plop the dude in front of a flag. Why do you have to come here?
Oh, he's using it as a dolly.
Rolling? Yeah, rolling.
Okay.
Picture a bald eagle soaring. Shit. What? Okay, just keep rolling. Tights wide. Just get me some.
He's gonna run back with that water.
Oh yes.
He had a big meeting there today.
Okay, here's what you're gonna do.
Oh God. Oh no. Everyone's gonna come out and see him. Oh my God. Bunch, get back in.
Yeah, you gotta go.
Rhubarb. That's the signal.
Stick it in your nose.
Would you mind if the guys and I took a picture with you? It would mean a lot to us.
Yeah.
Oh,
pictures.
Oh,
give me the camera. Here's your water.
Thank
you so much. Thank you. Smile.
Jeez.
Oh!
I didn't get it. That's good. Wow. I'm impressed. Oh,
I lost Mesa Verde.
What?
Thanks, Chuck.
I thought I had him.
That's why we're a team. Something like this happens. You're there to help me. I'm there to help you.
Huh. See, he's unsure. Mm-hmm. Mm. Damn. Mm-hmm.
Want some popsicles?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I did everything you said, but he's not getting any better.
He did good, Ernie.
He told me he wanted me to stay.
It's okay. I'm here now.
Is he gonna sabotage?
Come on, you gotta hear that.
That was Jimmy.
Oh, it's him. Okay.
I need an X-Acto knife, ruler, wood, please, hammer mill premium paper, 20 pound, one ream, and a glue stick. Oh, and point me to your best copier.
To do his own forms? Like...
What is he doing?
Oh, jeez.
He's going to switch it around.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my God. To go through all that effort.
And then make a copy of it. Hopefully there's no little lines around it.
My
God. Wow. Holy
my
crap.
My gosh. Whoa.
That's so wrong.
What do you think so?
At least Chuck's doing it by the book, though. I mean, he's not.
Yes.
Yes, he is.
Wow. To go through all that effort.
Oh, my gosh.
He put posties right where he took everything.
Oh, gosh.
To actually leave. Just figuring out he's going to be out.
This is for Kim. No turning back.
Where's Ernesto?
And don't get mad at Ernie. He spent the better part of a day watching you do your impression of a baked potato. I told him to go home and get some shut-eye.
Thanks for staying with me. If things were reversed, I hope you know that I would do the same for you.
I doubt that, but...
Yeah, I don't know.
It sounds nice.
You know, I gotta tell you, you are much smarter than I was when I was your age.
Maybe you needed better teachers.
That could be.
Why don't you have to wear them?
Because Pop-Pop's a grown-up, and grown-ups get to be stupid. Now put them
down. Good answer.
Whoa, look at
this. Good job. Can we do more? Squeeze.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you line them up for me. Give me a hug.
Aww.
Ooh, love you, girl.
What is he doing, like a barbed wire thing?
I guess so.
Thank you, honey.
Oh my goodness.
my God.
Oh my goodness, what's he doing?
So is he going to put that up as his own security system, I guess?
Yeah, I was wondering what the heck he's doing. Yeah, I don't know.
Maybe.
Yeah.
He's always so calm about things, yes, and he knows how to handle, like, when those guys broke into his house last time. So he's probably doing, like, extra
around
security
the
system. Yeah,
oh,
probably
yeah,
around there.
Garden. Garden.
How crazy, oh, like,
idea.
A good activity for him and his grandkid. And,
that's right.
Oh, just saying, you know, water some plants.
Goodness.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
Thanks, honey. You helped your grandpapa.
That's right. That's cute.
Ooh, those nails, they were so long,
yeah.
Too. How smart.
So uninteresting.
I've never made a sprinkler like that, so I was like, oh, well, maybe I would.
They do come in handy. I mean, it's really nice, but.
Yeah.
Have you ever done that, like drilled holes in a hose to make it sprinkle?
You can buy them like that.
But I wonder if people do that. Like, yeah, have you guys ever done
probably,
that?
Probably, if they have an old hose hanging around, they don't want to.
Have you guys ever tried?
Stand around.
That's right.
Yeah.
Watering.
They don't
want to
pay for
plantings.
New ones.
So I like this episode from the thumbnail. I quickly saw it, and I just made up this whole situation where I thought Saul, Mike, and people were in the desert, and something bad was going down with Tio or something. So nothing to do with that.
Yeah.
But Mike is really good being on stakeout, you know, and just looking from afar and even in broad daylight.
Yes.
I'm like, I'd be so nervous to do that, but he just sticks to it.
And Fifi is the plane.
Yes, Fifi is
the plane. Yeah.
Yeah, so that was fun going to Saul, going to Jimmy. That was big. Yeah, that was impressive.
Yeah.
Again, like, of course, it's not some old man who can't talk. It's
that's right. So he was probably doing some commercial.
Mm-hmm.
Like
probably for his business
elder
or something.
Law.
Like
yeah,
that, yes.
That's what it seemed like.
Yeah. And they used a dolly. They used a wheelchair as a dolly.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my
yeah,
God,
the cheapest kind of
fun.
Dolly
yeah.
You can get.
Oh.
Hey, there you go. That would still be bumpy, though, because you're on gravel or whatnot.
Yeah. And he's not supposed to say.
Than walking.
And the old man is not supposed to say anything. And at the end, when he's taking the picture, cheese.
It still worked, though, but you're right. I was like, oh, no, don't say cheese. But at least he didn't say a sentence, but he couldn't say anything before. He's like,
no.
So he was a good actor, too, just like playing the part like that. And yeah, so I think Jimmy is making a commercial for his own firm now, just to advertise for that. But I feel so bad for Kim.
She
was in the right to keep those people because she was the one that handed them to HHM, and she should have been able to walk with them.
And shame on Chuck for doing what he did.
And it's hard because she was working for HHM at the time when they were brought in.
Yeah.
So they did a follow-up, which really sucks. If they really respected Kim, they would have let that go, but it's money, and all comes down to the money
pride
that they stole it away from her again. And they said compliments.
Right.
They didn't say anything bad. They had to make sure they only
complimented
her.
No, but they made it.
But she's only one person, an individual.
Right. Yes,
and
they completely buried her.
Have to know XYZ, have to know all these boring things that are very important. But you guys know that. She knows that. So it was great.
Right.
And that's what he does with his life, Chuck. Like,
that's
for
right,
him
yeah.
to be able to turn things around like that, he has this disease that he even tricks himself into believing.
Jimmy did go to his house. He got the documents and stuff, and he more or less
he altered the address.
Altered him, yes.
Yeah. So that, okay, I love that scene. That was insane that that worked, but he knows his brother very well and how sickly he gets, and he sleeps for so long. Mm. How did you feel about that? Were you happy that Jimmy did that, or?
I was kind of happy because Chuck was pretty brutal about Kim. I mean, she lost a huge client, her sole client. That was going to be her sole income.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it's typical Jimmy style.
That's right.
It's not right.
Yeah, that isn't
but
right.
But it's
going
to make everything, like when they mail everything to Mesa Verde, they're going to be, it's not going to get to
bad.
Them.
It's not going to get
all going to be late. It's all going to be mm-hmm. you know, kicked back to them, and they're gonna have to scramble to get things on time.
Yeah.
And it's gonna just look like a big blemish, and they're gonna say, wait a minute.
They're totally gonna go back to our
documents is wrong.
Yeah. And Jimmy even staying the night because he cared about his brother. He dismissed the other guy who was supposed to stay. And Chuck even said that right when he woke up. That's the first thing he says, because it's always about like what he wants. And he's like, well, I said this to him. He was supposed to stay. Why isn't he here? So I'm glad that Jimmy just bit it and said, listen, I told him to go. I was here, you know?
Yes. He's been here long enough looking at you like a baked potato.
Yeah. But I wish Jimmy didn't stay there, because now with all those documents being messed up, Chuck is going to connect the dots, I think, later on and be like, he was here overnight definitely. And I slept a long time, so he could have done something. Not that he would think he would go that far, but he doesn't trust Jimmy anyways and always judges him. Now, of course, I know we all agree that Jimmy did a wrong thing, though, and I am rooting for Jimmy, but honestly, Chuck, they're doing things by the book. And even though they are messing with Kim,
it's not apples to apples.
That's what it isn't.
And Jimmy's doing something very illegal. He's actually messing with legal documents.
That's right.
Yes. So it is very mean what Chuck did, but yes.
That's so wrong. Yeah.
He did it legally. It's an interesting debate because it's not straightforward. Like, I don't like what Chuck's doing at all. Mm-hmm. And he's really good at it, but he's still doing things by the book, even questioning mm-hmm. Jimmy and challenging Jimmy with everything else that he's done in the past. Like, he does manipulate things and he does things illegally a lot, you know? Like, hence the commercial, too. Like, you weren't supposed to take. I don't even know how that's going to happen. Like, he's going to make a commercial of that Fifi plane, and he's probably going to get in trouble for that because he didn't have permission. He probably has to sign something to say it's okay.
Yeah, and the only way he got out there was because he had a vet that flew that plane.
Yeah.
Like it. So
so if he makes a lawyer commercial with him standing, how is he going to get away with it? You know what I mean? Like,
and that poor captain that okayed it, he might get in trouble.
He might get fired or something because.
Yeah, they might.
Oh, well, I didn't. How do you explain that? I don't know. Like, you don't expect something like that. Man. Yeah, it's a really good show. And Jimmy, again, we're following him and Kim, and I really enjoy, I mean, both of those characters are great, but I think Kim is really my favorite character right now.
I love Kim, and I feel so bad that she lost it.
Yeah.
And she didn't want to sign that lease because she doesn't.
It's scary.
Yeah, and she doesn't have income right now.
Yeah.
That's right.
And she was so elated when she got there because she really got the lawsuit that she wanted, but then it just sucks because you're in the moment and you want to go forward with this, but then when you lose your only source of income right now, like, I guess it makes you stronger. Yeah. I don't know. And I think she will get them back, but that is scary starting your own firm. But she did say the right thing because she got the respect back from Howard by saying that she didn't go with the other firm. So that was good.
Yes.
But I still didn't like how they did that power play of trying to guilt trip their clients to come back.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
You know, so it's scary. I'm happy they're going on their own. And I hope that they do well, at least for a while.
I do, too. I just, and, you know, she does have a great reputation, so I'm sure she'll get clientele quick, but
maybe smaller cases, too, because she's only one person.
Yeah,
so if you have a big lawsuit, you're going to want to have a lot of people, like, looking at every little detail, like Chuck is saying. Like, you want to make sure that they stay up because laws change all the time. You want to make sure they know exactly what they're talking about. Because one slip up. So this is great with what Jimmy did, because there's a lot of slip ups and it's not good.
Well,
so whoever did all that paperwork is going to get fired, and it's going to be bad for HHM. They're going to lose their clients. So, but Jimmy, to go that far, to go to a copy place to actually print out, you know, all that stuff, to actually sort through, like, how much time did it take to go through, like, plan ahead? Okay, well, you know,
every,
his brother.
Every letterhead.
Putting post-it notes and risking going somewhere to post all this, cut things out, exactly.
For him to wake sure up and, probably not even look at, well, he moved the boxes, so he probably would have looked at the boxes and said, I don't remember putting them there.
Did he put them exactly where they were before? I thought he put them back.
Then he put them back, but it while he was gone. Oh, were they put back?
Yeah, they were put back.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. He put everything back the way it was, I believe.
Okay.
Yeah, so he has no clue.
It's such a sneaky guy.
Yeah, he is. It's entertaining, but it just puts that feeling in my gut that I'm like, oh, guilt. I'm like, it just twists my stomach up because I'm like, that's so wrong that you did that. But I'm just annoyed at Chuck. And yeah, I just don't like what
they're
doing. Yeah,
because they have the Sandpiper deal. I mean, yes, it's a huge firm. They're not going to just live off of one client.
And this is Kim's initial start of her business. She needs something to start with. And if they were good people and they were friends of hers for so long, yes, they're paying for her loans and stuff, but I guess business is business and you're going to get eaten or survive. I don't know. So it just sucks that, you know, that happened. I was just hoping that they would be better than that, but no, they were proud and they stuck to it during the meeting to try to persuade them to go back to HHM.
Yeah, you know, she can try it for a half a year or something like that, or a year, and if it doesn't go well, she can always try to go to a firm again.
Right. Yeah. So we will see what happens, but I am happy they're starting their own practices together in the same place, but it is scary. Like, I feel their nervousness right now, because that's a huge step to take.
Yeah.
Again, knowing what happens with Jimmy later, I just don't know how that happens, but I know it doesn't last. But maybe it will for Kim. Maybe she'll grow into something big for that.
Hope so.
You know, in that building or whatever.
She deserves it.
She might be good. She does deserve it. She's really
good. And he was kind of like a cheerleader. Yeah, we can do this. And then when she walked away, he was
nervous too. Like, he's always very.
Yeah.
He's trying to be encouraging about it. But yeah, he's unsettled too. And I was kind of hoping for a bigger reaction between Howard and Chuck losing Kim.
Yeah,
definitely.
I mean, I could tell they cared a
especially
little
Howard.
Bit.
I mean,
but
she's been there for what, 10 years almost?
Yeah. Yes. And the fact that he was such a jerk, like right from the start, where he didn't even invite her into her into his office, and he was like, I don't have a lot of time. What do you need? You know?
Then
it stopped when she said, I'm starting my own place. Like, I'm starting my own
business. Yeah, because he was so dead on that she was going to go to the other firm, Schweiker.
Yeah. Which, again, like, it sucks in her position because she's been screwed over by HHM. They're being very mean to her and very unfair. And going to a different firm that they're going against because of the lawsuit, like, that's a huge lawsuit. So that's a huge slap in the face after everything HHM did. But what makes it right, you know, because then Kim's the one who's suffering a lot here.
That's right.
Anyways, I'm glad that she went this way with Jimmy because that was actually better and makes her look better.
But also, Kim did say something to Howard about she wanted to pay off the education that, you know, that he paid for.
Yeah.
And he told her that she doesn't have to pay him.
Right.
Back.
He
raped that's it. Good. Yeah. That's a really good thing. Yeah. So I'm really happy that he did that. Gracious. That's a good thing.
Yeah.
So I was happy to hear that because I thought he was going to be like, oh, well, we'll figure out a payment or something. But I'm like, oh, yeah. But no, that was nice. So I think we'll end it there, guys. Can't wait to watch more. Very good show.
Yes.
I always think something really bad
is
going to happen.
That's what Tio's doing, too.
Yeah, like the whole beginning with the trucks. I was like, oh, God, something's going to explode. It's like the worst thing. I'm like, no. And then I try to remember it's a different show. It doesn't mean that that's going to happen, but you never know. So thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe, and we'll see you very soon, as always. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Hi, Mom. Look at that. The badge, kind of, sort of.
Look at that.
Yay.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Subscribe.